trying time right now. Well, John Hubbard.
What?
Wants to discuss with you a lot of things that have gone on over the last 25 years. 25 years. He will call upon all of us to give us some idea of what has been going on in your lives. Most importantly, with the gap tonight, what's the treasurer's report?
Giles. This is Bert Giles. We live in Florida
winter. We lived in Miami for 23 years. But we live on wheels. We are full-time RVers. And we go where it's warm in the winter and cool in the summer. And we do have a permanent address because you have to be legal.
This crowd is legal.
I'm Doc Gallatin. My wife Ann Kennedy, most of you know, lives in Ipswich. We've lived in Florida, California, North Carolina, Georgia, but we're now back in Ipswich, and we live in Plum Island in the summertime and Ipswich in the wintertime.
Ready? You're up. You got a few minutes of time here while I get up. I don't want to hold up the roast beef or whatever. Tom Grapham, my wife Eva. We're still residents of Ipswich, and I'm still working.
Next,
Fred Cronin. My wife Kay, we live in Persephone, New Jersey, and we're retired 4.5 years.
I'm Dal Matheson. I tried to say hello to everybody. I don't know if you've seen everybody yet, but I'll see you later anyway. This is my wife, Thelma. I've known her for 50 years. We've been married 43 years now. That's the best thing I ever did.
Frank Williams, my wife Marge, and we're presently retired in Damariscotta, Maine, and before that, we're traveling.
Okay, next. Joe, tell us who you are.
Yeah, who that?
All right. Joe Hinckley, my wife Virginia. We're quietly living in Ipswich. We're quietly retired.
Abby.
George.
And this is my husband Charles Maceos. And we're in Ipswich. Hi,
welcome.
I'd like to say something about Abby.
You do, and I'll flatten you.
Joe, you don't have enough time tonight.
I retired to Georgia, and Abby picked up most of my responsibilities for this party tonight.
Oh, no, Abby. Everybody.
Tell them exactly what happened.
Yes.
Hey, you and Betty ran away.
Everybody went, and they went to Florida for what? It's terrible down there.
Joe went.
Smart telling. I'm here with my friends Abby and Mary, who I grew up with.
I'm Mary Dodge Dennis, and I'm with Doris in Abbey. My husband passed away 5 years ago, so I'm alone now. I never got out of town except for my traveling, and I retired about 7 years ago, and I do want to give Charlie Basales a big hand for all the work he's done on this.
Don Perkins. I left Ipswich in.
Good.
Never.
That bad.
That's San Diego here.
I left Ipswich in 1953 and went to Michigan and left Michigan 8 years ago to retire to San Diego, California. Just close to Bob.
Who's your wife?
This is my wife, Mary Jane. And we met the revolving door.
I'm Marjorie Dyler, and I live
just across the street.
Oh,
sorry. We'll have to walk. Right?
Hank?
See, I'm Henry Myers. I live in Beverly now. I used to live in Salem. From Ipswich to Salem to Beverly. Still in Beverly.
Choo-choo! Choo-choo!
Pets and Zurus, my wife's daughters, and we live in Beverly, and I'm still working here in Salem.
Mm. Barbara, and I can't remember where I took her after the junior prom. She didn't tell me.
I'm Barbara Craig Judge. This is my living for 43 years. Doing okay. We don't expect to resolve it at this point. We are living in Naples, Florida in the winter, and we have a summer place at Lovell Lake in New Hampshire. We have the best of both worlds.
Mm-hmm. I'm Virginia Oliver Toffee, and this is my husband George, retired from the Navy, and we live in Norfolk, Virginia.
I spend my time between Florida and New Hampshire. I lost my husband last year, so I'm here with this Miss Cool.
Oh, yeah. Now we get over to this table. Right here. Ruth?
Ruth. Mm-hmm. I'm Ruth Andrew Blaze, and I haven't strayed too far. I live in Middleton, and I lost my husband 2 years ago. I'm glad to see everybody here tonight.
Willie!
Yeah, Willie!
Hey.
Oh. Willie, don't mind.
Willie!
Known as Willie, but my wife Pat been putting up with me for 38 years, and we're still living in Ipswich, and I'm like some of these guys, I'm still working, so life goes on.
I'm Betty Bushy Stewart. This is my husband Frank, and I still live in Ipswich, but I don't spend too much time here. I come home to change the clothes. We spend our winters in Florida, and we just came back from Alaska. Now we've hit a whole 50 states, so I hope I stay home for a while.
Great.
I'm Ed Salzberg. I summer in Ipswich and winter in Essex.
I didn't know that.
I'm Dorothy Critch Cleveland. My husband of 46 years is house sitting for Ruth tonight. We've had a wonderful time. We were in the service for over 20 years. And I'm really glad to be here tonight and see all of you. It's really a great, great experience.
How do I work this? I gotta take a picture of you.
Just watch through here.
And do what?
And just keep me in there. Don't touch a thing.
Don't touch a thing. Don't you move your goddamn hand.
Well, I won't be working.
Let me get underneath there for a minute.
Can I get over here?
So I can get over here.
And keep you.
And I guess you all know that I used to be known as Alonzo Ram, but I'm more familiarly known now as Al Ram. And my wife, Peg, who happens to be John's sister. And you may recognize her. We live in Long Island. We've been there since 1949. But we keep coming back to Ipswich. I retired a year or so ago. And never been so busy in my life. We enjoy doing this video bit. And as Don Perkins said, he'd like to have a copy. If anybody else would, just give me a note or put it and sign a sheet or something, and I'll be happy to make one. It won't be edited, but it'll be... and with this lighting, I'm not sure how good it'll be, but it'll be it anyway.
Whatever you do, don't let Doug Fogler handle the finances.
John Hubbard.
We got it.
I still live in...
I'm an owl.
Well, I still live up in Peterborough, New Hampshire. I winter in Peterborough and I go south for the summer.
Oh,
Jeff.
Oh, Jeffrey.
I'm keeping busy. I'm retired. I've been retired for 11 years. Somebody told me I've been retired for 30 years.
Oh.
So I keep busy playing golf and tennis and bowling and being in plays. Been in, on the stage for about 30 years. You couldn't tell that. But,
hey, John, what about the walk?
I just finished Guys and Dolls, by the way.
Hey.
Okay.
No,
yeah.
No. John, what about the walks on 1A?
The
walks to
the walks to with Billy?
Really?
Oh. What do you mean, no?
Why? Well, what about
I don't I'm not sure why you brought that up. Hey, Don. Don Perkins has a little announcement you'd like to make.
I just like to deliver a message to you from George Grant. George Grant has been quite ill this last year, and he lives about 15 miles from me. And I haven't been able to visit him. He said he don't want me to come over because he has aphasia, and he doesn't like to speak with people. But he wanted to say hello to everybody tonight, and he wanted me to get some pictures from all of you. George was a master plumber after he got out of the Navy. He's a good friend of Stanley Lawson's, if you remember.
Yeah.
He also was in the class.
Yeah.
And he wanted to say hello to everybody tonight.
Right?
Walter Akramovich.
Sure.
Whitney Appleton. Winifred Bailey. Peter Chinopoulos. Madeline Davis. Richard Davis. Gene Emerson. Stella Karinus. No, Scott? Karinus. Stanley Loss. Ann Mansfield. Audrey Mode. Anthony Morosky. Charlotte Noel, Michael Pappas, Stephen Prisbolo, and Mary Williams. All of them.
Remember when
it was a good idea to have a moment of silence for those people. Here's a moment of silence, please.
Winnie Mansfield.
They didn't hear you.
A moment of silence for the past deceased members of the class.
Girl.
She's still here.
Yes. She's with us tonight.
What a
Elena Strangman. And the class lovers were Anthony Morosky and Alice Beckwith. So, there you are. Best dressed boy was Eddie Salzberg.
What was that? Oh, best dressed boy.
Best dressed girl was Pauline.
Yeah. For a sweater.
The artist was Francis Mason.
Where is she?
Anybody know where Francis Mason is?
Oh, he have a last shot.
There you are.
Did he ever get married?
When I was a young man courting the girls, I played me a waiting game. If a maid refused me with tossing curls, I'd let the old earth take a couple of whirls while I plied her with tears in lieu of pearls. And as time came around, she came my way. As time came around, she came. When you meet with the young girls early in the spring, you court them in song and rhyme. They answer with words and a clover ring, but if you could examine the goods they bring, they have little to offer but the songs they sing and a plentiful waste of time of day. A plentiful waste of time. Days grow short when you reach September, when the autumn weather turns the leaves to flame. Hasn't got time for the waiting game. Oh, the days dwindle down to a precious few. September, precious days I'll spend with you. These precious days I'll spend.
Brains as time goes on.